Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. All my brothers and sisters, this is Pastor Jolly Lasse. Today, our church, normally we were doing the church service in one of the Anglican church. They are fully occupied today. Because of this reason, today I am preaching the gospel, doing the church service, share the word of God in the street. Praise the Lord. My church service took off today morning. We had chat with them. Now I am preaching the gospel in the street today. This is a church service. Praise the Lord. Coming Sunday onwards, I will be in the church. And also I am praying to Lord to get on church in London and all the places. Praise the Lord. God bless you. Thank you very much. Praise the Lord. Wonderful church service. I will be preaching the gospel.
Praise the Lord.
And share the good news. Another 1 hour time. After that, praise the Lord, I'll be going back to my home. Praise the Lord. God bless you once again more. I want to pray right now to the nations. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray for this place right now. During the time of this word of God, during the time of sharing this word of God, Heavenly Father, I bless them, Father. Keep everybody in your glory. The people are walking in the city center. Praise the Lord. Bless them, Father. Keep them in your glory. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. God bless you. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Just want to sing one song right now. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a strength, oh, glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God. Born of His Spirit, washed in His blood. This is my story, this is my soul, praising my Savior, all that He loves. This is my story, this is my soul, praising my Savior, all that He loves. Perfect submission, perfect delight, visions of rapture now burst on my sight. Angels descending, spring from above, born of His Spirit, washed in His blood. This is my story, this is my soul, praising my Savior, all that He loves. This is my story, this is my soul, praising my Savior, all that He loves. Praising my Savior, all that He loves. Praising my Savior, all that He loves. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a force. Oh, glory divine, heir of salvation, purchase of God, born of His Spirit, washed in His blood. This is my story, this is my soul, praising my Savior, all that He wrote. This is my story, this is my soul, praising my Savior, all that He wrote. Perfect submission, perfect delight, visions of rapture now burst on my side. Angels descending bring from above echoes of mercy, whispers of love. This is my story, this is my soul, praising my Savior, all that He wrote. This is my story, this is my soul, praising my Savior, all that He wrote. Praising my Savior, all that He wrote. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, and worship your holy name. You're rich in love and you're slow to anger. Your name is great and your heart is kind. For all your goodness I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, and worship your holy name. You're rich in love and you're slow to anger. Your name is great and your heart is kind. For all your goodness I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, and worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, and worship your holy name. You're rich in love and you're slow to anger. Your name is great and your heart is kind. For all your goodness I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, and worship His holy name. Sing like never before, worship your holy name. You deserve the glory and the honor. Lord, I lift our hands in worship. As we lift your holy name, you deserve the glory and the honor. Lord, I lift our hands in worship. As we lift your holy name, for you are great. Your miracles so great. There is no one else like you. There is no one else like you. You are great. Welcome, Holy Spirit. Be you with your praise. You want to pray 1 minute? You want to pray 1 minute?
What religion are you?
What religion are you? You want to pray 1 minute? You want to pray 1 minute? You want me to pray 1 minute? What's your name? Okay. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray for sister right now, only having the walking difficulty. In the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus Christ, I declare the proper strength and power in the leg, all the feet right now. In Jesus' name. By his stripes, this is already healed right now. In Jesus' name. Release the healing right now. In Jesus' name. Can I lay my hand on head? Can I lay my hand on head? The name of Jesus Christ, thank you for touching right now. In Jesus' name, Baba. Amen. You can walk properly. The power of the Lord move. Praise the Lord. Even if this is a church service, I will never call anybody. People are coming. Healing will happen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Because healing power is moving right now. Welcome, Holy Spirit. Be here with your presence. Fill us with your power. Live inside of me. Welcome, Holy Spirit. Be here with your presence. Fill us with your power. Live inside of me. You are living water, never dying fountain. Comforter and counselor, take and be control. You are living water, never dying fountain. Comforter and counselor, take complete control. Welcome, Holy Spirit. Be here with your presence. Fill us with your power. Live inside of me. Live inside of me. Live inside of me. Praise the Lord. All the brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus. Today my church service in the street. I want to suppose to preach in the church. The church which I have hired, they got some, the church got occupied. Praise the Lord. There are some functions is going on in the church. Because of this reason today, I am preaching the street, spread the gospel. This is a church service. I will never call everybody. Normally, when I was preaching the gospel, I was calling everybody for the prayer. But today I will never call anybody. You can hear this word of God. Anybody would like to come to me during the time of hearing this word of God, I can pray for you. God will heal. Praise the Lord. Today, just I want to read today, praise the Lord, book of Mark, chapter 3, verses 1 onwards. Book of Mark, chapter 3, verses 1 onwards. In this, I can say to all the people, the healing of Jesus Christ Praise the Lord. It was happening. Bible says, a man who was having a withered hand, praise the Lord, he was there. Just want to read a couple of Bible verses today. Before that, I want to pray to all the people. During the time of share this word of God. Heavenly Father, I pray for each one of them. During the time of share this word of God, another 30 to 40 minute time, thank you for your sending, your power, your anointing to the nations right now. Heavenly Father, I bless them, the people, those who are hearing this word of God. Heavenly Father, I bless them. Give them in a glory. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. God bless you. Thank you very much. I would like to read today book of Mark chapter 3 verses 1 onwards. Jesus Christ was healing a person who was having with a withered hand. Before I read this chapter, I want to say the nature of Jesus Christ is a healing nature. Praise the Lord. God bless you. God bless you. The nature of Jesus Christ is a healing nature. Healing is a nature of our Lord. Wherever Jesus Christ was preaching the gospel, whenever Jesus Christ was preaching the gospel, the healing power, it was moving to the people. How it has happened like that? Because the people, those who heard, those who are hearing this word of God, they were having the faith in them to receive the healing in their heart. Book of Mark, chapter 3, verses 1, Bible says, another time, Jesus went into the synagogue. Praise the Lord. And a man who was having withered hand was there. Some of them were looking for a reason to accuse Jesus too. So they watched him closely to see if he would heal him on the Sabbath. You know that one. When the time of during the time of the public ministry of Jesus Christ, all the people, those who are living in this world, they were believing, they were living under the law of Moses. They were having a certain custom among themselves. What was the custom? They themselves created the custom for the people. On the seventh day, healing should not happen. On the seventh day, nobody can do, people cannot do anything in their life. This was the wrong custom created by the high priest and all the people who are in the ministry level in the synagogue in the Jerusalem temple. This was the Jewish custom. But when Jesus Christ came to this world, Jesus Christ was breaking all the customs of the Jewish people. What was the custom? What was the custom? That means the custom was all the Jewish people, they were teaching the wrong way to the people. Even if any of the people want to do something in the Sabbath day, receive the healing and everything, the Jewish custom, they should not receive any of the healing. But Jesus Christ was breaking all the customs of the Jewish people. Jesus Christ was explaining to all the Jewish people in that time, my Father, the God is working in all the days, in all the time, in everywhere, any time, any other moment. Even if it is Sabbath day, does it not yet? My Father is still working. Praise the Lord. This was the custom. Jesus Christ was breaking all the customs of the Jewish people. Verses 2 Bible says, all the Jewish people, they were looking at Jesus Christ, whether Jesus Christ was healing this person who was having the withered hand on the Sabbath day. Verse 3 says, Jesus said to them, said to the man with the withered hand, stand up in front of everyone. Praise the Lord. Jesus Christ was saying to the person who was having the withered hand, stand up. Praise the Lord. God bless you. Stand up in front of everyone. When this fourth is, then Jesus asked them, which is lawful on the Sabbath, to do a good or to do evil, to save life or to kill. Praise the Lord. But they remained silent. Jesus Christ was asking a question to all the Jewish people, those who were gathered in the synagogue, in the temple. Jesus Christ was asking to them, praise the Lord, what Jesus Christ was asking to the people, which is lawful on the Sabbath, to do good or to do evil, to save life or to kill. But they remained silent. Praise the Lord. Verse 5 says, he looked around at them in an anger and deeply distressed at their distressed at their stubborn hearts, said to the man, stretch out your hand. He stretched it out, and his hand was completely restored. In this we can see one thing. Jesus Christ was breaking the unlawful custom of the Jewish people. Bible says very clearly, the manifestation of Jesus Christ in this world to get everybody, each and every people, the life everlasting. Bible says the people, those who are believing in Jesus Christ, they will never get perished. But all the people, they are getting life everlasting, eternal life. When Jesus Christ was doing his public ministry in this world, Jesus Christ was not only saying the work of the Heavenly Father, but he was doing by his work and showing to everybody. Praise the Lord. This is the will of the Heavenly Father, to do the good things even if it is a Sabbath day. Today, I want to say to all the people, in Jesus Christ, there is a healing each and every day. Does it matter what is your situation? Does it matter what is your circumstances? doesn't matter which country you are from. The person, the people, those who believe in him, 24 hours a day, 365 days a year, each and every fraction of second, our God is ready to do the miracle in your life. Jesus Christ was saying to each one of you, if you are doing the fellowship with God, your prayer answer, your hearing, it is very near to you. 100% you can receive the hearing in your body. How this person who was having the withered hand received the hearing? Because he went to the synagogue to worship our God. Another thing, I want to say to each one of you, Book of Mark, chapter 3, verses 1 to 6, when we are reading, we can see only one thing. The person who was having the sickness, that time, even if he is a sick person, he was a sick person, he was not at all sitting in his house. He went to the synagogue for worshiping our God. When Jesus Christ went to the synagogue, what happened? Jesus Christ saw that person who is having passion to receive the healing. Today, church service is very important. As I say, I want to say one thing to all the people are walking here. Shake the nations is arranging the church service every Sunday. This is a higher church, not in our own church. Today that church got occupied. But my mind was saying, do not go and preach the gospel. This was the negative thoughts. Again I said to myself, again I got one more thoughts in my mind. Go and preach the gospel in the city. Why don't you do the church service on the street? I came to know this is the voice of the Lord. This is the reason today I am standing with you today to spread the gospel to the nations. According to this Bible, the person who was having the withered hand, he was in the Jerusalem temple. He went for the worship in the synagogue. Jesus Christ had been there. Jesus Christ saw him. Because of this reason, Jesus Christ healed that person. My question again, if you are suffering any of the sickness today, most of the people are losing their church service because your child is not well. You are not well. I want to say one thing to all the people. If you are not well, you have to take a taxi or any other car, rent a car or anything. You have to come and attend the church service. In the church service, there is a miracle. In the church service, the healing it will happen. In the church service, there will be a deliverance. In the church service, our God's presence, it will come to you. Doesn't matter wherever you are, the presence of the Lord, it will come to you. So Jesus Christ said to that man, stretch out your hand. He stretched it out and his hand was completely restored. In the Bible, in another way, I can say this person who was having the withered hand, he was believing. He was having the desire in his hand. One day, our God will heal him. What was his desire in his heart? Our God has seen his desire. After that, our God is giving the answer of his desire. Today, I want to say one thing to all the people. According to the word of God, each and every healing and deliverance is happening in your life because of your desire in Christ Jesus. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. This I want to say today. Jesus Christ was doing the healing and miracle in this world by the divine power. The same power raised Jesus Christ from the dead to the life. Today, I am preaching about this divine and mighty power. Praise the Lord. Today, what is the power? The power that means we have received this power from the heaven. This power is nothing but the Spirit of God. Bible says, the same Spirit raised Jesus Christ from the dead to the life. Today I am preaching about this mighty power to each one of you. All the people are walking here. Book of 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 7, Bible says, but we have this treasure in earthen vessels, by the excellence of the power maybe of God and not to us. We have got this power in our heart. This power can do the creative miracle in your life. Today, I want to say to each one of you, this is a Holy Spirit generation. The Spirit of God can do anything, any of the miracle, anytime in your life. But I want to say one thing to all the people. Are you ready to receive the miracle in your heart today? Are you ready to receive the miracle in your heart today? If you are ready, according to the Bible, book of Mark, chapter 3, verses 1 to 6, the person who was having the withered hand, he went to synagogue for worshipping God. If you want to get something from the Lord today, we should get out, come out from your house, come out from your anxiety, come out from your laziness. Come out from your house and worship our God in spirit and truth. Our God is required from you. You need to worship our God in spirit and truth. Each and every people, I want to say to each one of you, in this church service, I want to say, Bible says, but we have this pressure in earthen vessels. That is the power of the Lord.
Oh shit.
This ain't power. All that is disciples of Jesus Christ. They have received this power. Book of Acts, chapter 1 and 2. When they worship our God in the Jerusalem temple, the promise of the Lord. The promise of the Lord, that means Jesus Christ said, I will send the promise from the heaven, the Spirit of God. When the Spirit is coming to you, this Spirit will teach you about me and what I have said in this world. About that, this Spirit will teach you. What is the commandment of the Lord? This Spirit of God will reveal. This Spirit of God will reveal you about your future, about your past thing, and what you are supposed to do in your life. So today, all the ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, I want to say one thing to all the people. All the disciples of Jesus Christ, when they gathered in the Jerusalem, they could receive this mighty power of the Holy Spirit. Today, I want to say to each one of you, this power is in you today. This is what Apostle Paul said. The Christ is in you, the hope of glory. The glorious one, the creative power is sitting in your heart today. One question I want to ask to each one of you. Are you ready to receive this power from the heaven today? If you are ready, our God can do anything for you in your life. Apostle Paul, he was persecuted of the church of God. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verses 8. Even if he was having lots of problems in his life, the Spirit of God, when it came to his heart, he left everything what was his possessions. He forgot everything, the old things, what he was having in his life. He was preaching the gospel in Samaria, Judea, and Jerusalem, in the uttermost part of the world. So today, 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verses 8, in this Bible says, we are hard pressed on every side, yet not crushed. We are perplexed, but not despair. Verse 9 says, persecuted, but not forsaken. Struck down, but not destroyed. All this carry about in the body, the time of the Lord Jesus, that the life of Jesus also may be manifested in our body. Apostle Paul, he was saying, we are hard pressed on every side, but not crushed. Nobody can destroy us, because the one who is appointed me to preach the gospel, he is greater than everything. He is the creator of the world. So today, I want to say to each one of you, I am preaching about this creator of the world. Maybe you are believing Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior. in your difficult situation. Even if like that, even if you are still serving our Lord, according to the Bible, our God will see the work you desire, the work which you have done for. Apostle Paul, when he came to know Jesus Christ, he is his Lord and Savior. He left everything, what he was possessed from this world. He was saying, we are hard pressed on every side. The friends, the Jewish people, praise the Lord, the soldiers, he was the 14 days in the midst of the sea in the ship. Even if it was happening like that, he was saying, praise the Lord, he was saying, we are perplexed but not in despair. In each and every places, each and every time, the world people are rejecting us. That doesn't matter. The spirit which is there in my heart. One day, he Apostle Paul was saying, I was prosecuted the church of God one day. But today, by the grace of God, I came to know the power of the Lord. I came to know the miracle of the Lord. I came to know the loving kindness of the Lord. I came to know the mercy of the Lord. Because of this reason, nobody can separate me from the love of God. Praise the Lord. Persecution, forsaken, all these things cannot separate me from the love of God. Praise the Lord. He was saying, we are hard pressed on every side, yet not crushed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Struck down, but not destroyed. Praise the Lord. All this carrying about in the body, the day of the Lord Jesus. That the life of Jesus also may be manifested in our body. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Again, Romans chapter 5, verses 5, Bible says, Book of Romans, chapter 5, verses 5. In this Bible says, praise the Lord, now hope does not disappoint, because the love of God has been poured out in our hearts by the Holy Spirit who was given to us. Each and every people, those who are walking here, even if the world of people will say, today is the day of your life, today maybe you are at the point of the death, you cannot able to come out from your deadly life. But Bible says, if the Spirit of God is in there in your heart, the Spirit of God will come and deliver you from all kind of your persecutions. The Spirit of God can get you a new hope in your life. The Spirit of God can deliver you from your all kind of distress, anxiety, and persecution. The Spirit of God can get you a better life. Today, when I am preaching this gospel to the nations, one thing today, I want to say to each one of you, the people are walking in the city center, Jesus Christ will never leave you nor forsake you. The nature of Jesus Christ will never leave you nor forsake you. The nature of Jesus Christ is the loving kindness. The nature of Jesus Christ, he is the living God. The nature of Jesus Christ, having the loving heart. Today, under the 10 minutes time, I want to close this session. Before that, I want to say to each one of you, in Jesus' name, if you are having the hope in your heart, our God will never forget you. In the Bible, Gospel John chapter 5. There was a person who was having 38 years infirmity. What happened? He was waiting to get the touch from the Lord. That means, Gospel Mark chapter 3, the person who was having the withered hand, he was in the synagogue. That means in the presence of the Lord. The person who was having 38 years infirmity, he was also in the place called the presence of the Lord. The pool of Bethesda, always the presence of the Lord, it was there. Today, any of the people are suffering your sickness here today. I want to say one thing to all the people. Any of the places you are there, in that place, is there any of the presence of the Lord? Is there in that place? According to the Bible today, I can say 100%, your all the situation, it will get changed by the presence of the Lord. Your all the sickness, our God can heal you by His presence. His living power, it will come to you. Like Apostle Paul. What Apostle Paul said? The same way, you will get a reason to say from your mouth, we are hard pressed on every side, yet not crushed. We are perplexed, but not despair, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not persecuted, forsaken. Struck down, but not destroyed. Always carrying about in the body the dying of the Lord Jesus, that the life of Jesus also may be manifested in our body. So today, before I end this session, I want to ask to each one of you, if you want to get something from the Lord, we have to carry the presence of the Lord. Who we can carry the presence of the Lord? How we can carry the presence of the Lord? We can carry the presence of the Lord when you're doing the fellowship with our Lord. When you're doing the fellowship with our Lord, the presence of the Lord, it will come to you. In other words, in the God's presence, impossible things will happen in your life. Let us raise our hand. We can pray 1 minute to the Lord. Heavenly Father, I pray for each one of them. Because of this street church service today, the people are walking online, watching online. People are hearing this word of God. Heavenly Father, you went to the synagogue and healed the person who was having the withered hand. Even if the Sabbath day, you are breaking the custom of the Jewish people. And you are showing the Father in the heaven is working in all the time, in every way, everywhere, each and every flash of second, in all the time, even in the Sabbath day. Heavenly Father, I bless this city. I bless this people, those who are walking in the citizen. In this Sunday, may your God bless each one of them in Jesus' name. Spiritually, physically, in all the areas. Once again more, I pray for each one of them. Let all the people receive your power and glory in them. May our God bless you, each one of you. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. God bless you. Thank you very much. Next week, there will be usual church service in the church. God bless you. Thank you very much. Okay. Thank you very much. People are watching online. It was a wonderful session. God bless you. Thank you very much.
Yazıyorum. 20 lira yazıyorum.